Welcome to this tropical tiny home that is 3 hours outside of Sao Paulo, Brazil. I absolutely love the location of this Airbnb. It is deep in the forest, and there is a big river just a 10-second walk away from this property. You can hear it at all times. Just the sound of the water going in the background is super peaceful. You also have some very nice outdoor amenities, like a wood-powered hot tub. And then the interior is unlike anything I've seen before. It kind of feels like a combination of both rustic and boho interior design styles. So I'm really pumped to show off this tiny home to you all. So strap in, let's now go and start the full tour. Welcome to this tropical tiny home in Brazil. I love the green paint job on this Airbnb. It all just blends in perfectly to the jungle surroundings. And you have this very large outdoor deck. I'll get into some of the exact specifics in a short while. And this is what the side of the home looks like with more of the windows. Now, to begin to go into some more specifics, as mentioned earlier, my favorite part of this property is the exterior as a whole, especially all of the amenities. There is a fire pit here. I didn't quite have enough time to use it because I only had one night, and I was focused on the wood-powered hot tub that you see here. You load some wood up into that hole there, and you can see everything is getting smoked up, and I'm starting to warm up the hot tub. It does take a couple hours, but there are also two tubs that you see here. So one of them is the wood-powered hot tub, but the one next to it has more cold water. So you can go from hot to cold very easily. You essentially have your own little private spa in the jungle. Next, right near the main entrance, there is a small chair and some decorations. And you can also hang this hammock across these two hooks. It's very easy to put up, and of course it's green, so it just matches with the home and all of your surroundings. This is what it looks like a little more zoomed out. After that, I'll just focus more briefly on the jungle. You have your lovely sitting area here right next to the river with a big bench and a small chair. And this is a pretty serious river, guys. The current seemed pretty strong to me. The water is very loud yet very relaxing. It's the perfect escape. And this is what you're going to see as soon as you exit the home. You have very thick green foliage, tall plants and trees. All of this is on all four sides of this home. It's the perfect setting. But that's it for everything outside, so let's now go and check out the interior. We'll start first in the main room, which is comprised of your dining area, the living room, and the kitchen. But as mentioned earlier, this feels like boho meets rustic, with a bit of a white and beige color scheme. And it's a very open concept with windows and doors everywhere that you look. Starting on the left, you have a simple dining table here with five chairs, and I love the big golden leaf platter right in the middle of the table. Next, there is your kitchen, which has all of your major kitchen appliances like your fridge and freezer, your oven and stovetop, and a microwave. There's also a good amount of countertop space like you see here, and all of your plates and bowls and pots are out in the open, and there's more up top. For the final area in this room, you have a small living room that's more like a chill out space. You have these two big cushions, which look a bit like a couch, and then there are some decorations along the white wall. Let's move further into the home now. So I'll walk down this hallway, and at the end, you can find the main bathroom. There is a large shower in the background, and then your toilets can be found in this corner. Just outside in the hallway is the sink. The light white and beige color scheme continues, and you can find the same countertop that we saw in the kitchen. For the last room in this side of the home, we're gonna go into the first bedroom. You can open up these windows so that you can wake up to the views of the jungle as soon as you start your day. And there are a few other things in that corner as well, but you pretty much have windows on all sides. I also love that giant leaf decoration right above the bed. And there are a few things like a heater, a fan, and even a smart TV. Let's exit the bedroom now and go to the top floor. I will get there via this white spiral staircase, and there is your second bedroom. It's pretty simple with your mattress and a white storage bin over there on the left, but the best part definitely has to be this window. I mean, just look at this view. I know I'm saying it a lot, but I seriously cannot get enough of all of the green foliage. In that far corner, there's also a small desk or table with a blanket and another heater. And there's actually a half bathroom up here. So if you need to use the bathroom at 2 a.m., you don't have to stumble down the spiral staircase in the dark. So very convenient. That's it for this home, but I want to briefly mention their other unit. It's called the Barn of Luz or the Barn of Light. It's really neat. It looks like a greenhouse with some cool lighting fixtures, essentially. It's a little on the smaller side though, so I couldn't quite justify a full dedicated tour, but I still want to show you. You have this nice outdoor seating area with these big chairs, a fire pit, and a table, but let's now briefly go inside. The interior is a bit of a studio setup. You have your kitchen there on the left that I'm walking past, then your comfy black couch and a mattress. Further in is a small table, some storage space, and you even have this large bathtub and your bathroom there on the right. Let me know which of the two Airbnbs that you like more down in the comments, and I'll see you all very soon for another Airbnb tour.